I know that we are young, and I know that you may love me, but I just can't be with you like this anymore. Alejandro.
And sealed, a new start. After a year of tough negotiations, Russia and the U.S. have finally put pen to paper on the much-anticipated Strategic Arms Reduction Treaty.
This is a big victory, and I think it's significant as well that you noted that even after these reductions, they're still going to have significant stockpiles on each side. First, it needs 67 votes in the U.S. Senate. That means you can't just do it with Democrats like they largely did on health care. You need 67 votes. You need a lot of Republican votes. White House aides in private are saying that they don't have the votes right now.
We can do this. Hell no, you can't. Hell no, you can't. Hell no, you can't.
No, no, no.
I want Barack Obama to see.
No, we're not the party of no. We're the party of hell. We're the party of hell, hell, hell.
If the election were today, I do not think Obama would be reelected. But 3 years from now, things could change if say he played the war card. Say he decided to declare war.
You're not suggesting that he would cynically play the war card.
What insight into Russian actions, particularly in the last couple of weeks, does the proximity of the state give you?
They're our next-door neighbors, and you can actually see Russia from land here in Alaska.
Well, explain to me why that enhances your foreign policy credentials.
Well, it certainly does. As Putin rears his head and comes into the airspace of the United States of America, where do they go? It's Alaska.
He sent out this alert. Governor Sarah Palin warns war may be necessary if Russia invades another country. In the interview, Palin said if the Republic of Georgia joins NATO and Russia attacks, then the U.S. could very well go to war.
Otherwise,
under the NATO treaty, wouldn't we then have to go to war if Russia went into Georgia?
Perhaps so. I mean, that is the agreement when you are a NATO ally, is if another country is attacked, you're going to be expected to be called upon.
The verdict of an independent European Union report on the five-day conflict
The investigation, compiled by around 30 experts, sought to clear up some unanswered questions surrounding the violence. Well, it was in August of last year when Georgia launched a massive military assault on the South Ossetian capital, killing civilians and devastating infrastructure.
When Georgian troops rolled into Tsinvali, capital of the breakaway region of South Ossetia, on the morning of August the 8th this year, they were confident of victory. Their arrival was preceded by an all-night bombardment of the small town by Georgian artillery that resulted in many civilian deaths.
The United States cannot continue to take the path of aggression. You saw the recent reports about now some people are discovering that maybe Georgia was the aggressor. I knew that when it first happened. Anybody could see that. And yet that was used to try to attack Russia.
I know from speaking this morning to the president of Georgia, Misha Saakashvili, who I have known for many years, told him that I know I speak for every American when I say to him, today we are all Georgians.
The Georgian president chews over his next move. Is he weaker or stronger than before?
John McCain said that Americans are supporting Georgia. McCain said, we are Georgians today. Everybody are Georgians today.
We're the party of hell.
I have directed a series of steps to demonstrate our solidarity with the Georgian people. I've also directed Secretary of Defense Bob Gates to begin a humanitarian mission to the people of Georgia headed by the United States military. This mission will be vigorous and ongoing. A US C-17 aircraft with humanitarian supplies is on its way. And in the days ahead, we will use U.S. aircraft as well as naval forces.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I understand we're sending aid to Georgia right now, humanitarian aid in a military vessel, military ship. If we're not the provocateurs, why would we use a military ship instead of a non-military ship? What's the purpose of that if it isn't to provoke? We should all agree that when you give humanitarian aid, it's essentially military aid because all funds are fungible. And it just happens that the Georgians in their budget last year spent 70% of their money on the military, and they got a lot of assistance from us. So this idea that's humanitarian aid and not military aid, I think, distracts from what's really going on there. But I was just wondering whether it ever bothers you or concerns you, or the question ever crosses your mind about, humanitarian aid to a country like this. What about the people in this country? We have a lot of poor people not getting medical care and not getting food. And $1 billion, huh, what the heck? We'll send them another billion. Does it ever cross your mind that maybe that should be helping our people here? And this is getting us into trouble. This isn't helping us. This is making us less safe. This is part of this empire. You might refer to it as our sphere of influence, but everybody knows it's our empire. But does it ever cross your mind that everything that we do over there and every nickel you take, you're taking it away from some poor people in this country that could have been helped?
I don't think of it that way, no, sir. Secondly, as a matter of fact, Georgia did not attack Russia. There is no question about
One
that.
One week after Georgia's incursion into Ossetia, the rating of Republican McCain went up, and for the first time in this campaign, leveled out with Democrat Obama's rating, and then gained a few points.
Play the war card.
Thank you.
we continue covering South Ossetian conflict. A day of mourning will be held across Russia on Wednesday to mourn those who lost their lives in the South Ossetia war. Flags will be flown at half-mast throughout the country. During 5 days of violence, tens of thousands have fled to neighboring Russian regions to escape the devastating attacks. Russian peacekeepers have the Republic's war-torn capital under control. The city has been left in ruins and some villages nearby razed to the ground. Work is now being carried out to provide humanitarian aid to those who are still there, as well as to restore electricity, gas, and water supplies to the city. As the noise of shooting and shelling died down in the conflict zone, their place is taken by the crying of desperate victims. Following Georgia's attack on South Ossetia, it's now hard to find a citizen who has not lost a relative in the conflict. With the humanitarian corridor now completely under peacekeepers' control, convoys of refugees continue to stream into Russia's southern regions.
The Russians are trying to ensure the security of their forces and their citizens and their peacekeepers.
Well, we seem to have lost our line there to the press conference. We're the party of hell.
George Bush and Saakashvili should answer to the crimes that are being committed. The killing of innocent people and the running over of graves and running over with tanks of women and children and throwing grenades into cellars to kill innocent people. That's not, war is supposed to be military against military. Georgians are killing innocent civilians. They're committing genocide.
But probably you have a question. Why Russia came to protect South Ossetia? But Saakashvili's regime, killing 66 Russian peacekeepers and 692 Russian citizens, committed a crime against Russia. These peacekeepers are called peacekeepers because they mustn't shoot them. Some of our citizens hid there, hoping that they wouldn't be attacked. But they attacked and inflicted airstrikes on whatever they liked. The peacekeepers' mission is to support peace in conflict regions. To kill a peacekeeper is a serious war crime. Even 10 years ago, a weakened Russia might have accepted this blow, but modern Russia is not going to put up with wrong. For each crime, Russia has an adequate response. On the 8th of August, the South Ossetian Press and Information Committee broadcast an appeal from the Republic's citizens to President Dmitry Medvedev. We should remind you that the majority of Ossetians have Russian passports and citizenship. These Russians appeal to their president from Sinval's basement to save their lives, their homes, and their republic.
Members of the House Foreign Affairs Committee side with Russia.
The recent fighting in Georgia and in its breakaway provinces was started by Georgia. The Georgians broke the truce, not the Russians. And no amount of talk of provocation and all this other stuff can alter that fact.
We don't need to be in Georgia protecting a pipeline. We're not there for democracy. We're there to protect an oil pipeline. And that, to me, is tragic.
In the interview, Palin said if the Republic of Georgia joins NATO and Russia attacks, then the U.S. could very well go to war.
Otherwise, under the NATO treaty, wouldn't we then have to go to war if Russia went into Georgia?
Perhaps so. I mean, that is the agreement.
Thank you.
your president decided to do it on Olympic night, open of Olympics, and he starts shooting at the, with the artillery fire this on sleeping town.
Where he started shooting?
On the capital of South Ossetia, Tsinghua.
I'm American citizen, freedom of speech, and I have opinion about what's happening to
us. Well, they got nothing, you know?
Today is Tuesday, the 19th. They just passed by me and spit on me and spit right on my American passport. They said they're gonna kill me as usual. I just called police. It's 7 o'clock at night, so I hope I'll be still alive in the campaign.
Why are you taking pictures of me? Huh?
What happened? Today is what? August 19th?
August 19th.
10 p.m.
There was about 10 demonstrators from Georgia.
9:45.
And they marched over here after they had given up.
Uh-huh.
And they verbally assaulted us.
Uh-huh.
And they put these...
What did they say?
They thought I was Russian.
Okay.
And they said, you don't know what you're talking about. They said, you should learn more about what's going on in Georgia. And then they threw these... They started yelling at us. But they were angry, very angry.
But they didn't say anything about killing you or...
No, I told them, I said, you should be making love, not war.
Yeah. I
said, you should be loving each other. Because, why fight?
Because to me, they said, we'll kill you. As I told you, they spit on my passport before.
She would have done that if I challenged them more.
I wasn't challenging anybody. I was sitting quiet. They came, spit on my passport. I showed them that
she was threatening. They were threatening.
They had a very tribal attitude.
Very tribal.
Tribal.
Oh, yeah. They had their war paint on.
I think they are kind of organized. One of this Orange Revolution situation.
Well, worked up. My relatives are killed in the top of this.
Okay. I'm not taking anybody's side.
I don't think they are. I live in New York since 1989. I don't believe that here, from the UN, I'm going to get killed. Okay. I think they're smart. I'm going to stroke them.
I'm not taking anybody's side. Born and raised here, my parents were born and raised here. I'm not Georgian, I'm not Russian. I'm just saying, you have a right to have an opinion. But there's a lot of them, you're running them up and they get in the wrong. They're telling me
they're
bad things, but I don't want nobody to get hurt. I'm just giving you advice. That's okay.
The New York one
told me
I have a right to speak, so...
I know, okay. Don't worry about New York
one.
Just worry about me and worry about
the... I need to set up the...
No, I'm just a police officer that wants everything to be peaceful. Okay.
I'm here too. I'm just
keep what I said in mind. That's all. Alrighty.
Thank you so much.
Alright.
No, they came to protect us, not just kidding.
We had threats.
All the New Yorkers, not only...
Well, read about.
Okay.
Right here, the mosque in New York.
Yeah.
You'll know why. Finally, they pay attention to us. Because we have different view than U.S. government and Georgia.
Yeah.
So Georgia is trying to... They're threatening, they broke my camera, they keep the police and doing things. Finally, they're doing but little late.
Yes,
where are you from?
Spain.
Spain. Oh, I love Spain. I'm from Spain, from Barcelona.
You don't agree with him.
If you don't agree with somebody else, somebody else has a different opinion.
Doesn't matter. No.
I'm not arresting you.
Let them
speak. You fuck out?
Everyone relax.
Look, here's my deal. Don't bother this guy. Is that clear enough?
Okay, pretty simple.
Don't bother this guy. The only thing what I did, officer, was I just took the pictures of the sun. That's
it. But what about them?
I was not.
He put the camera in my face.
Guys.
Just leave the guy alone. You understand that? Otherwise, I'll break you up.
You want to protest? No one cares. You want to protest? Fine. Stay away from each other.
Yeah, no problem. I came out to you.
I have no problem with you, but those two guys.
That's it. No, we don't have to talk about it. Let me just tell you something.
broken by standing there. Don't lie. Don't lie. Don't lie.
Look, just go do your thing. We're discussing now. We're talking about it. Just go
sit over there. My passport. Can I have a dog?
I'll lock up every person.
Hey, where's the passport? Just go hang out. Do what you guys want to
do. You look good, by the way, today. You don't look like something happened to your relatives in there.
Oh, really?
Very happy. Yeah, and handsome.
He's not that.
So don't tell me. Don't tell me things about paid and everything. You get paid with success.
Oh, yes.
My relatives died, and I'm here for that. Okay?
My dear,
what
relatives?
I'm 17 years. Can you give me your name? Give me your office number, and I need your information when you.
It's all there, right here.
Right, where is your name and information?
Can you my name
right
in the back.
Where? Right where?
Search. Okay, now the police is coming. You go on now.
No, you have
your
last
friend
name.
No, I don't give you my name because
so
you threatened to kill me. Did I ever give my name?
Hey.
You threatened to kill me. You're going to give me my name? Your friends. I will record it.
No.
Yes.
No.
Now what you can tell me?
This is a misleading information. And
well, you have misleading information. I believe in this information.
Why are you shaking? We're not going to kill you. Calm down.
Okay, why don't go on? Okay, go
on. No, just a last name. Yeah.
I don't give you a last name. So you find what I mean?
You just
I know,
the information.
I don't think I'm crazy. Read the go on the website, see what your friends tell me about killing.
You
the police coming, you gotta move on. Leave me alone.
Now tell me about myself.
Why don't leave me alone? Why don't leave me alone?
No, I'm not leaving you alone. But tell me, as you said, your relatives died.
Okay, well here's
I have a right.
Well, here's the deal. No, nobody's allowed to stay here. We're not allowed.
Okay.
Nobody's allowed to stop.
I don't want them to do this.
Well, they're freedom of speech.
They're not allowed to do that.
Do they allow to be as the white and we not allowed to be here? They
are.
Death threats from your president supporters.
Yeah.
So I'm not giving my last name.
Okay, so what's your name?
Sergio.
And could you tell us what's the purpose of your meeting today here?
I have a different name.
Just a moment. Present yourself.
Hi, my name is Sergio. I'm an American citizen.
Yeah.
I live here since 1989. And I was appalled by action of your president. I never been in one of political actions before, but I just couldn't sit at home and let it happen.
Yeah.
Can I ask you one favor? What is your permit?
What is my what?
Permit.
I have a permit.
Show me.
Are you a policeman?
Yes, I am.
Show me your accreditation.
First of all, I'm asking you,
okay,
show
I'm
me.
Ask police. It's not Georgia. You have freedom of speech here. And unfortunately, your friends don't have understanding of this. It's not Georgia when you kill
you
your
really
opposition, put them in jail. I know
Do
that
you really?
your president attacks our association in violation
that's,
of the.
That's
yes.
Not true.
Yes.
Wrong.
And I'm not the only one
Georgian
protecting
territory
about
and the war in Georgian territory. Russia bombed Georgia.
Well, you don't have to
convince
me. If you have your opinion,
no,
I have my opinion.
No, in Russia.
And I have a lot of information.
You're in the wrong way.
You don't have to convince me. You're the newsmaker.
Can you yes? So do you have anything to say? I mean, can you just come more about this protest?
I protested the killing of innocent people that your president killed overnight with the carpet bombing, with artillery fire. And you know, I don't have to tell you. You're trying to shut me up. It's against American principles. I have my right. I have my right. Don't teach me. I know my rules. I know. I've been talking to police. I've been to speak to many people. And they don't
mind. Could not you pay $45 to get a permit?
What?
Could not you get it? $45 from the package?
Leave me alone.
We're not having this.
Leave me alone.
Thank you.
Are you guys the Ossetians here?
Huh?
Are you Ossetians?
Yeah,
we were just there. We were in South Ossetia.
Oh, right.
Yeah, my name's Andrew.
I keep my passport to try to stay alive here. It's been very tough. Very tough.
Do you guys live here in New York?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Saakashvili came out to speak to his supporters. He just had a speech. I'm all excited about it.
No, we support the people to hold stage because the problem is not. So do you say ready?
Yeah.
We're talking about the day is called. We're talking about the day.
Ну как, тебе нравится наша?
Вообще здорово.
Супер. Ты рад за нас?
Вообще, вообще.
It's fucking all it's about.
But it's not much of an oil there.
Right, but they need, it's a way to encircle Russia.
All
right. Right, right. You know, you by getting Georgia in NATO, by getting Poland in NATO, by getting Romania in NATO, I mean, it's isolating Russia.
That's right.
By isolating Russia, then you hope to drive a wedge between Iran and Russia because you want to take out Iran. Not because they're a threat to anybody. They spend $8 billion a year on the military. We spend $1 trillion. But if you take out Iran, they can't project power into the Middle East and you can control things.
But you cannot.
The United States is not going to be successful, by the way, but they think they will be. But it's important that you educate people.
Right.
Because the conversation has to happen. The American worker is the most ill-educated worker in the world. I mean, they're good people, they work hard, but they don't know squat about outside the United States. They don't know squat really about inside the United States. It's because they're lied to all the time, or it's not covered. I mean, did you notice? You probably guys probably noticed in the news how, you know, all of a sudden, you know, remember Russia a couple years ago, oh, they're the U.S. friends, like Cold War's over. Yeah. All of a sudden, it took the U.S. media like 24 hours to decide that it was the Russians who were the big bad guys in terms of Georgia.
If the Russians didn't get there, there'd be no Russians left.
NATO and Ukraine. If this summer that had been the situation, you might have had to go to war over the Georgia situation. Would you have been prepared to do that?
Well, I'm not going to deal with hypotheticals.
Well,
I have
really
been,
but I have been
a very strong proponent of the view that NATO is a military alliance.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a talk shop. And Article 5 means what it says. So there is a commitment to go to the assistance of our allies. If they are challenged.
Under the NATO treaty, wouldn't we then have to go to war if Russia went into Georgia?
Perhaps so.
Have to go to war if Russia went into Georgia?
Perhaps so.